Good morning, students. Welcome to the online teaching session of Academy World School Vivekananda. So here I am with the chapter Fundamental Unit of Life, that is Self. And in the previous lecture, I have discussed with you all what are the different structure of a cell. That is, first one is the plasma membrane. Then in between the fluid-filled space, that is the cytoplasm, and inside, that is the nucleus. Right? Three major portion. And in this diagram also, I have explained. We have discussed out of this few cell organelle and the part in a given, I have discussed how the transport is taking place. So today I will be discussing about the Golgi apparatus, chloroplast, that is the plastid, vacuum, and one more cell organelle, that is lysosome. So today you will be aware what are these cell organelle. Starting with the first one here for today, Golgi apparatus. See, this cell, what I have drawn here and I explained you last lecture also. So this is particularly a plant cell which will be having the cell wall. Only the plant cell is having the cell wall. Now whatever I will be telling, do compare that. This will be certain points there will be which will be different in plant and animal cell. See, cell wall, it is only present in the plant cell, and below to it there is a presence of plasma membrane. Plasma membrane or the cell membrane, it is present, right? And in the animal cell, this cell wall is absent. Only the outer covering is the plasma membrane, which is semi-permeable membrane. Inside to it, in our plant cell, you can see this big structure. This is the vacuole. And because of the presence of this big size vacuole, the nucleus is pushed toward the periphery, towards the plasma membrane at the corner. And this is the cytoplasm. I told you cytoplasm is of two types, that is, means there are two things, cytosol and cell organelle. Cell organelle, which is this part, which is the living part, which perform different functions. Now you know what is plasma membrane, you know about the structure of the nucleus, you know about mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell or storage battery, and you know also the endoplasmic reticulum, which is of two types. The rough endoplasmic reticulum, which will be having the ribosome, and within this ribosome, I told it will be somewhere spread also in the cytoplasm. One cell organelle is Golgi apparatus. In the plant cell, it is called dictyosome, and in the plant, it is spread also. It's in smaller size and it is spread in the plant. Whereas in the animal, this Golgi apparatus, it is complex structure. This Golgi apparatus is discovered by Camillo Golgi. So Camillo Golgi has discovered the structure Golgi apparatus. Now you can see here the structure. This seems like one after another vesicles are stacked together. So this Golgi apparatus, it consists of set of membrane bounded vesicle. Set of membrane bounded vesicle, because like this you can see the structure over there. It's all arranged parallel to each other. And there are some vacuoles also present around it. So it is a set of membrane bound vesicle, vacuoles, and flattened cisternae. This cisternae is the closed sac, which is stacked just one above the other parallelly. It is a part of endomembrane. You see here, it is a part of the endomembrane system in the cytoplasm. Because see, interior to it, there are different structures. I told you, endoplasmic reticulum means inside the cytoplasm only certain structures are there. So this is a kind of endomembrane system. Endomembrane system in the cytoplasm. Right? It is closely sometimes it is attached also with the help of ball gear apparatus. This will be doing that work. So this one, so it packages protein into membrane bound vesicles inside the cell before the vesicle are sent to their destination. Whatever product will be formed, it has to send to its destination where the work has to be done, where the requirement is there. So this Golgi apparatus will do the packaging thing. Fine. So I will be listing you some functions for this Golgi apparatus. Function. So major function of this will be, it helps in storage, modification and transportation of the product.
Lysosomes.
the bill has digestive enzymes and also called digestive bags. So in the previous lecture when I have drawn this diagram, I told this is the plant cell, but in the animal cell this lysosomes are present. I will draw with the help of this blue marker. You see, like this circular structure, it will be present in the animal cell, fine, and it will be numerous in the animal, not in the plant. In animal cell it is required much. Now you will be thinking, why in animals? Because we are heterotroph, we can't prepare our food. So what we do, we take the food, right? So when the function is like happening in the body, the digestion and other thing, so there are certain waste material and we are a complex organism. So to clear up the waste, there are requirement of these lysosomes which is having the digestive enzyme. And these digestive enzymes are also very harmful. Okay? See, it is helping for clearing up of the waste which is near to the cell or which are produced by the cell. Now, it is called the digestive bag. Lysosomes are present in only animal cells. It's not present in the plant cell. Now see, there are metabolism happening in the body. Metabolism means the formation or you know breakdown of the substances in the body. It's happening. So during this all metabolism happening in the body, it can happen that the cell get ruptured. So in that case, when the cell is getting ruptured, even this lysosome can burst. So accidentally it can happen. Accidentally, if during metabolism of cell, if the lysosomes rupture the digestive enzymes comes out of it and engulfs the nearby cells. Now see here, what it is doing? It is helping also in our body. Now it is having certain side effect only when it is broken up. When it gets ruptured or its guts open, the digestive enzyme which is very harmful and it is inside that bag, right? Digestive bag, I told, digestive bag. So it's a sac like structure. So that sac, if it's burst open, that enzyme is coming out. It's very harmful and powerful enzyme. So near to it, whatever things will be there, all that surrounding will be eaten up by the lysosome. So because of this reason, this lysosome is also called as suicidal bag. Hence, it is called as suicidal bag. And do remember this term, because this lysosome, it is present. This lysosome is essential. See, we are getting exposed to so many microbes all around us that will be entering our body. Not anything can enter inside the body and can, you know, make harm. So the function of lysosomes. It's one cell organ, right? So its one function is it helps in intracellular digestion. It helps in intracellular digestion means the things which are there inside the body which is not required, it will be cleared by the lysosome.
According to the presence
It is of following three types. Now this plastid is having some pigment. Accordingly, we will be differentiating the three types. So here, the first type I will discuss is about chloroplast. The second type will be chromoplast, and the third one will be leukoplast. According to pigment, just for you to understand, I will tell you what pigments are there. This chloroplast have green pigment. It is having only green pigment. Chromoplast, it is having colored pigment except green color. It is having only green pigment. Chloroplast, chromoplast, colored pigment except green color, because green color will be there only in the chloroplast. And this one, leukoplast, this is colorless plastic, no color will be there. Fine, this is the leukoplast. So these are the three types, and the most, you know, common one, which is more useful for the plant, which will help for the photosynthesis, that is chloroplast. Because here, chlorophyll pigment is present, which help in photosynthesis. It's also one of the function for this chloroplast. It's the green pigment, chlorophyll. Here chlorophyll will be present, which help in photosynthesis process, one of the major process for the production of food. That's why plant called autotroph. They are preparing their own food. And due to this major function, this chloroplast is also called kitchen of cell. Now you all might be seeing this video and your mother might be cooking something in the home. So you know, in the kitchen there are food getting prepared. In the plant, this chloroplast is the major cell organelle, type of plastid, which will help for the preparation of the food. So it's called the kitchen of the cell. All the food preparation will be done in this part only, with the help of chlorophyll pigment. Without this chlorophyll, no food preparation will be taking place. And there is one important thing, that is the structure of this chloroplast. How do they look like? Here I have just drawn structure, how it will be. But inside structure, you should be knowing what are the structure inside this, means internal structure of a chloroplast. So for that, I will be rubbing this, because I am going to draw this internal structure of the chloroplast. Internal structure. Internal structure of chloroplast. So when you draw, I told it's a discoidal structure. So first you can draw that discoidal structure like this. And it is double membranous. So just draw one more line around this discoidal structure. So it will become double membranous. And this double membranous structure is called the upper one and the lower, inside one. Outer membrane, inner membrane is called envelope. You can write envelope, or you can just label outer membrane, inner membrane. You are free for that. How you can remember or understand, you can write envelope. These are the two membrane envelope, right? And inside it. Now, see it carefully. Inside this envelope, there will be a circular like structure. Like you might have seen the coins, 5 rupee coin. So that 5 rupee coin, if you put one above the other, it will be stacked. where the light reaction or the chemical reaction takes place and photosynthesis is taking place. It's called kitchen of the cell or kitchen house of the cell. Now this is one type, chloroplast. Now what about the other pigment? This was the major type. The other one is the chromoplast. So the second type is chromoplast. This chromoplast, it's called the colored plastic. It's called the color plastic or the colored pigment will be here, and that colored pigment, if I name carotenoid, is one pigment which will give different color, red, orange, yellow, all that color will be there. And the main function of it, this will be the color of flowers and fruits. The colors of the flowers and fruits are due to the presence of chromoplast, the colored plastic or the colored pigment which is present. Because of that we see colorful flowers and fruits all around us. So this is one major function. And you know, the flower, if it's colorful, then it will attract more insect and the pollination will be there. So everything whatever is around us is having some significance. So this is having a significance, that the flower is more attracting, has more colors, it will attract the insect for pollination. So the coloration in the plant, what we see, except I told you colored plastic, except green color. So this will be chromoplast. And the last type of the plastic is leucoplast. So the one I told, chloroplast. Second I told, chromoplast. Third one is leucoplast. So basically these are, I told green, even this is green plastic color except green, and this one is colorless. No color will be there in the leucoplast. And these leucoplast cells have a major function of storage. That storage cell will be present in the stem part and the root part. So it is having one major function. It is present, I will write, it is present, it is present in the storage cell of, it is present in the storage cell of root and underground, root and underground stem. So it will help for storage purpose. This is the third type of plastic. So there are total three types of plastic, and this plastic are only present in plant. So here if you want, you can mention only in plant cells. This plastic is present only in the plant cell. Now moving to the last cell organelle, what we need to discuss according to your syllabus, that is vacuoles. Vacuole structure, you can see in the diagram in the plant cell how big it is. It is fluid, fill or solid field. It is storage along with fluid field or solid field. Main purpose will be storage only, and it can be in the form of fluid or it can be in the form of solid membrane bounded structure. And it will be having a membrane, means outer covering will be there. So here you see, I have labeled here, if this is a vacuole in case of plant. See, plant, I have already explained that in a plant the vacuole, I told you that these vacuole will be bigger in size, and in plant it takes almost 90% of space. So major part will be covered with this vacuole. As plant are autotroph, they are preparing their food. So this will be storing the food inside it. This is called the cell sac inside part. Cell sac, because it is a fluid space and it will be having watery solution. Cell sac means it will have the watery solution. This watery solution will rich in sugar, amino acid, protein, mineral and even metabolic byproduct. Whatever metabolic things, means metabolism byproduct will be there, that will be stored here in this vacuole. And outer layer, this line what we draw is the tonoplast, the outer cover of the vacuole. So here I will list outer cover is called tonoplast. In vacuole, inside tonoplast is, inside tonoplast is cell sac. I wrote, what is cell sac? Watery solution rich in sugar, amino acid, protein, mineral and metabolic byproduct. So that will be filled here. Now, in plants, vacuoles are big. Fine? Big and prominent structure. And I told you the function of it. But in animal, vacuoles are small or absent. In animals, vacuoles are small or absent, and if present, it will be storing only some protein, glycogen and water, not more. Means it's not having a very major function. So this is about the vacuole. And its major function, as I told, it will help for the storage of the food in the plant, in the cell sac, these things will be getting stored. So these are also, you can write as a major function for the vacuole. And even there is one more type of vacuole that is called the contractile vacuole. Contractile vacuole. Now what is this contractile vacuole? Or the food vacuole. Contractile vacuoles are present in the amoeba. I will tell you, even you know about amoeba, that is an irregular shape organism having the nucleus and the food vacuole. See, these vacuoles actually, contractile means who helps for the movement, and food vacuole means when there is any food substances, what it does, it extends its body to engulf this like this, and then it's surrounded completely. It becomes the food vacuole. It happens in the unicellular organism like amoeba. So this is certain terms which you will different organs in the body, right? That animal cell and the plant cell both are having certain differences. Now see, animal cell, it's very smaller in size, and the plant cell, it's bigger in size. Here, according to the cell organelle, plastids will be present in only plant. This outer covering, cell wall, it's present only in the plant, not in the animal. These are two differences. Apart from that, Golgi apparatus are smaller, not so complex. It's called dictyosome in the plant. In the animal, it's more complex structure. Lysosomes are present only in the animal cell, not in the plant cell. So these are certain differences in between the animal and the plant cell. That's why plants are stationary, but they can even produce food with the help of chloroplast, which is having the chlorophyll pigment. Yes. So as these cells are making our body and all the functions we are doing, this chapter is over, but do continue to read and do read the textbook also to understand the concept. And again, you can view the videos if you have some doubt. Your assignment will be uploaded in the ERP. Thank you.